So today we will see the relation between angular velocity and linear velocity, because for translational motion also we can define some angular quantities. So if you consider relation between angular velocity and linear velocity, linear velocity v vector, angular velocity we can consider as omega vector. So now if you consider a particle is, moving in a circular motion where the radius of circle is r. This is the initial position of particle, initial position is point A, and the final position you can consider in very small time interval the particle reaches to point B. So what we can consider, this is the initial position of particle, the initially the particle is present at point A, and finally in very small time interval dt the particle reaches to point B. So you can consider the small angle travelled by the particle is theta. Then what we can consider, we have one relation. So this we can consider arc length we can consider as S, and this radius is R and the angle is theta. From this we can write down the relation, S will be equals to what, R theta. Now if you differentiate both sides, then what you will get, ds by dt will be equals to what, R d theta by dt. Now ds by dt is known as what, velocity equals to what, R into omega. But as we know that omega as well as velocity both are vector quantities, so now we can represent them in two formats. If you see, v vector we can write down as r vector into omega vector, or v vector equals to what, omega vector cross r vector. Now we have to identify which of the following will be correct from these two, because both are not correct, because a cross b is not equals to, if you take a cross b is not equals to what, b cross a. So for this what we will do, here the particle is moving in anti-clockwise sense. So if you consider at point B, the velocity of the particle will be tangentially to the circle. So this is the velocity of particle and this is the radius vector. Now if you consider first one, first relation, V vector equals to what, R cross omega. From this if you take, if you apply the cross product, R cross, if you consider R cross omega, see the value of omega, the direction of omega if you talk about, in this case the direction of omega is outward, because the particle is moving in anti-clockwise direction. So when the particle is moving in anti-clockwise direction, how to find out the direction of omega? Just curl the fingers of right hand along the direction of motion of particle, then thumb will give you the direction of angular velocity as well as angular displacement. So in this case if you curl the fingers, the direction of omega you will get outward. So here the omega is outward and the r vector is this one. If you take the cross product, R cross omega, then thumb is pointing towards this direction, but in our case the velocity is in opposite direction. So what we can say, this relation is wrong. Now consider this, omega is outward, so omega and cross R, so where thumb is pointing towards the direction of V. So what we can say, this relation will be correct. So V vector is given by what, omega cross R vector. So this is the relation between linear velocity and angular velocity. Angular velocity we can define for circular motion as well as we can define for the particle moving in translational motion. So actually the formula that we have written, v vector equals to what, omega vector cross r vector, this formula directly we can write down as omega will be equals to what, v by r, if the particle is moving in circular path, directly circular motion. Because in that case velocity is always perpendicular to radius vector, but if the particle is not moving in circular path, velocity may or may not be perpendicular to the radius vector. So see how to write down this formula, omega will be written as v perpendicular by r, where v perpendicular means component of velocity, perpendicular to r vector divided by modulus of r vector. So here this one is important, if the particle is not moving in a circular path, the general formula we have to use, v perpendicular divided by r vector. V perpendicular means component of velocity perpendicular to r divided by magnitude of r vector. So based on this we will see one question. Now if you consider a car is moving with a speed of 10 meter per second in horizontal direction like this way, and here we have one observer. This is observer. The distance of the observer from the car is, you can consider what, 4 meter, clear? This distance is 4 meter, this point we can consider as A. Now after some time the car reaches to point B and the velocity here is same 10 meter per second because car is moving with uniform velocity. Then and this distance is 3 meter. Now in question actually what they will ask you, they will ask you find out the angular velocity of car with respect to observer, because what we have to define, angular quantities are always calculated with respect to some observer. So this is the observer, with respect to this observer we have to find out angular velocity of car at point A and angular velocity of car when it is at point B. So see this one, how to solve this. Now if you see the general formula, omega is given by v perpendicular by r. So actually r vector means the position vector from the observer to the particle. So this is observer, this is what, particle. So r vector we will draw like this, from observer to the particle. And where is the velocity? Velocity is in this direction. As you see from the diagram itself, what we can say here, velocity is perpendicular to what, r vector. So directly this formula we can use here. So omega will be equals to v perpendicular is 10 divided by r vector is 4. So it will be almost 2.5 radians per second. So at point A the angular velocity of car is 2.5 radian per second. Now if you consider point B, now while calculating for point B, first of all we will draw what, r vector. So r vector how to draw, from observer to the particle. So this is what, observer, and this is what, particle. Now in this case this is r vector. Where is the velocity? This is the direction of velocity. Now in this case if you see, this angle is not 90, means velocity is not perpendicular to r vector. So for that what we have to do, first of all we have to find out component of velocity that is perpendicular to r vector according to the formula. So here we will take the components of velocity. See always how to solve the questions, in these type of questions always take the component of velocity along the r vector and one component perpendicular to r vector. So see, this is r vector. This is what, velocity. This is how much, 10 meter per second. So the component of this, this angle you can consider as theta, that we can find out from the given values. Okay. So this is velocity. This velocity is 10. This angle is theta. Then the component of this 10 along this direction is 10 cos theta, and the component of this velocity perpendicular to this r is 10 sin theta. So 10 cos theta and 10 sin theta. Now see which component is perpendicular to r vector. This is r vector. So this component is along r vector, this component is perpendicular to this r vector. So what we can say, this component we have to consider. So at point B, omega at point B will be equals to what, 10 sin theta divided by r, and what will be the r vector. See this length is 3, this length is 4, so we can apply Pythagoras theorem. So what you will get, this length will be how much, 5 meter. So this will be what, 5. So answer will be what, 2 into sin theta. And how to find out theta? Again we can use triangle. This angle is theta, then this angle will be what, theta. Now if you use 10 theta, 10 theta is given by opposite by adjacent. So opposite is what, 4, divided by adjacent is 3. So theta will be equals to what, 10 inverse 4 by 3. So 10 inverse 4 by 3 is actually 53 degree. So if you replace here, so sin 53 is 2 into sin 53 is given by 4 by 5. So it answer will be how much? We can write down as 8 by 5 radians per second. So this is the application of these questions. Means directly we cannot use V by R. The concept is V perpendicular by R, where perpendicular means the component of velocity that is perpendicular to radius vector. Now one more question we will see based on this. Again same type of question. If you consider this distance is 10 meter, this velocity is 20 meter per second, particle is here and the observer is at the origin. This is observer. This angle they have given as 37 degree. Now again they are asking angular velocity of particle with respect to observer. So angular velocity of particle with respect to what? Observer, they are asking. So for this, what we have to do? Again, we have to consider r vector and v perpendicular. So omega is given by v perpendicular by r. Now see this one. So this is r vector. R vector means the vector from observer to the particle. So this is observer, this is particle. So this is what? R vector. Now this is velocity. Now this angle they have given as 37 degree. Then what we can say? This angle will be how much? 53. Angle from horizontal is 37. So angle from vertical will be how much? 53. Now this velocity is 20. Then the component of this 20 along this direction will be how much? 20 cos 53. And the component of this 20 along this direction is how much? 20 sin 53. So which component is perpendicular to the r vector? This is r vector. This vector, this velocity is along r vector, and this vector velocity is perpendicular to r vector. So which component we have to consider? 20 sin 53. So omega we can write down as 20 sin 53 divided by r vector is already given as 10. So answer will be what? 20 by 10 into sin 53 is 4 by 5. So again answer what you will get? 8 by 5 radians per second. So based on this, it is very important concept, means we have to remember the formulas with the proper values that we are using. If directly we will run V by R, then we can make mistake. So in that format, we have to remember the formulas V perpendicular by R vector.